Hello everyone, welcome to another new episode of BookTales by Pritha. In today's episode, I will talk about a book which was published recently but has become an international bestseller. The book in question is Robin Sharma's The 5 AM Club, Own Your Morning, Elevate Your Life. In this book, obviously as the title suggests, Robin Sharma has told about how you can control your waking up in the morning. This book is particularly ideal for people like me who are late risers, who prefer sleeping late and in turn get up late in the morning. But this book, The 5 AM Club, the author has told what are the different ways by which you can get up early in the morning, what are the different benefits of getting up early in the morning, and why do many successful people in the world follow this principle of getting up early in the morning. So, to know more about this particular book, you have to watch this video till the end. But before that, have you subscribed to my channel, Book Tales by Pritha? If not, do subscribe my channel by clicking the bell icon just over here. Next, if you want to know more about Book Tales by Pritha, then you must follow Book Tales by Pritha in Instagram by the same name. We are also there in Facebook, wherein we have a Facebook group and a Facebook page by the same name. In Twitter, it is my personal account, which is @PrithaSarkar18. So do follow these social media mediums and get to know more about Book Tales by Pritha. Before I start today's video, you can also check out the blog wherein I have written a full-length review on this particular book, The 5 AM Club. And let me know in the comment section how you like my blog as well as how are you liking today's video. So, without further ado, let's start the video. In this particular book, The 5 AM Club, obviously the core and the gist is about getting up at 5 AM in the morning. What are the benefits of getting up early and how you can get up early in the morning? But there are many other things that has been told in the book through story, through different principles, which you can definitely apply in your life. Firstly, it begins with a story wherein a motivational speaker has gone to a seminar to give a speech. Therein, there is a lady entrepreneur who is depressed, there is a frustrated artist, and there is a simple person sitting next to them. They all have gone to the seminar to hear the motivational speech. Later on, when these three people interact, they get to know that the simple man who was sitting next to them is actually a millennial, but it cannot be recognized from his appearance. This particular person tells these two young chaps to meet him early tomorrow next morning at a particular place. When the next morning these two people go to meet him, he asks them, "Do you realize that why I have called you to meet me at this time, this early morning period of the day?" Obviously, the other two have got no answer. He says that if you start functioning early, your productivity would be tripled as you perform more activity than the other people in your surrounding. Also, if you get up early in the morning, it is our brain that functions at the fastest pace at this point of time. And as the time passes and we move towards the lunchtime or towards the afternoon, the pace of the brain functioning slowly starts reducing. So, the best time of the day, according to this billionaire, as told by Robin Sharma in this particular book, is 5 AM to 8 AM in the morning. In this time of the entire day, plan your entire day and start working or functioning in the order you have planned your entire day. Also, he has told about the four pillars of human life. These four pillars are mindset, heart set, soul set, and health set. The health set is where we are talking about the health. The mindset is where we are talking about positive thoughts. The soul set is one where he is talking about spirituality, about meditation. And there is the heart set, which talks about the emotional well-being of a man or a person. Next, one of the most important formulas or principles that Robin Sharma has told here, he has also time and again told this in his podcast and in his different motivational videos which I have seen in YouTube, is the 20 by 20 by 20 formula. Now, what is this particular formula? He is telling that divide the time from 5 a.m. to 6 a.m. into 3 sets of 20 minutes. The first set, that is from 5 a.m. to 5:20 a.m., that is just after you wake up, try to go for exercise. The exercise can be walking, jogging, something that makes you sweat and perspire. Once you do this, your mind starts functioning in a better manner. The next set that he has told is the reflection set, where he is telling do different writing activities. The writing can be writing your journal or planning your entire day. This is the second point of time, that is from 5:20 to 5:40. And the last set that he has spoken is from 5:40 to 6 a.m., which is the growth or analysis phase, where he tells read different books, read podcast, read different kind of newspapers, read all types of things that you may be interested in, watch videos on YouTube, hear podcast or audiobooks. So the more you can get more knowledge, that is the time that you should that is what you should do in this particular point of time from 5:40 to 6 a.m. He has also told about the performance phase and the recovery phase. He says that just as you have to perform well to gain better productivity, similarly you should also relax and take interval between your work to give more output. So we see in this particular book, which is I guess around of 336 pages, Robin Sharma has made a combination of a story as well as of direct knowledge or information. What we find in non-fictional book, either there is only a story, maybe I can give you the example over here of the book Alchemist, where there is a story of the shepherd boy from which we as reader have to get the moral and understand the what the author Paulo Coelho had tried to say from that particular story Alchemist. There are non-fiction books which also gives us, like there is books like Think and Grow Rich, which has given examples of different activities that you could do for your well-being, that has been mentioned over here. But the uniqueness of this book, the 5 AM club, is that Robin Sharma has tried to club in a story as well as direct knowledge and tried to give you in this particular book. So if you read this book, you will get to know many things. First, you will get to know this 20 by 20 by 20 formula. You will get to know the relaxation phase and the performance phase, and how and why you should balance. The core importance or the core thing that he wanted to say from this particular book is, why should you as an individual should get up early or at 5 a.m. in the morning. He has also told about the four pillars of life. Again, in this book, though it is not mentioned, I have seen it in a particular video of Robin Sharma, which I would like to mention it over here, because I think to some extent it is related with this getting up early in the morning. He tells about 90 by 90 by 1 formula or principle. Now, what is this particular formula or principle? He says that take any particular goal that you want to achieve. Do it for 90 days regularly. 90 days means a 3 months period. And in this 90 days period, spend 90 minutes of every day doing that one particular activity. You will realize by the end of 90 days that whether you have achieved that particular goal that you want to achieve, whether that goal that you want to achieve is actually for you, are you still interested in obtaining that goal in an advanced level or not. So this you can also try out in getting up early in the morning. I know it is not very easy to get up early in the morning all of a sudden, particularly if you sleep at late nights. So try to do it for 90 days. See whether like if you want to get up at 5 a.m. in the morning, researchers always say that sleep for 7 to 8 hours. So for getting up at 5 a.m. in the morning, you need to go to bed by 10 or 11 p.m. Again, in this particular book, Robin Sharma has told that try to switch off your gadgets at least 2 hours before going to sleep. So if you are targeting to go to sleep at 10 p.m. at night, try to switch off your gadgets, your mobile, your laptop by 8 p.m. Well, he's telling that the blue light that comes out from this laptop or from the mobile is not particularly good for a sound, peaceful sleep. So before you go to sleep, at least 2 hours prior to going to sleep, you must switch off all your gadgets. So I understand that it is not very easy all of a sudden to switch off your gadgets by 8 p.m. and go to sleep by 10 p.m. So try to achieve this goal by setting up this 90 by 90 by 1 principle. See whether you are successful in achieving this particular thing at the end of 3 months. Now, I have given you the example of this principle for getting up early in the morning. You can try it out for other goals. Maybe somebody wants to learn dancing, somebody wants to learn to play a piano. Try this out, follow this principle, and let me know in the comment section below that if at all you have been successful in achieving any of the goal that you want to achieve by this particular principle. Now let me know how you like today's video. Have you read any other book by Robin Sharma? By any other book, obviously I mean The Monk Who Sold His Ferrari. If you want to buy this amazing book or you want to buy The Monk Who Sold His Ferrari, I have given the link in the description section below. All my videos contain the link of the books that I mentioned in my video. Please buy from those particular link, because if you buy from those particular link, then I would be able to get a small commission from there, from which I can buy more books and I can share my knowledge with you about those books in this platform of YouTube. Do follow me in Facebook, wherein there is BookTales by Pritha, there is a Facebook page as well as there is a Facebook group. Also, we are there in Instagram by the same name, BookTales by Pritha. In Twitter, the account is @PrithaSharkar18. So do follow me in all this platform to get to know more about BookTales by Pritha. And I would be seeing you soon in my next video, which would come up next week, because I make these kind of videos on books, on life hacks, on fictitious book as well as non-fiction book, and try to impart whatever little knowledge I give from those books to you all. I hope you like my video, and tata, and thanks for watching my video.